So what I really need is a quick, easy flip that's going to make some instant cash. And through a friend of a friend, there's an SL specialist, Mercedes SL. It's got a lovely car, the right engine, the right year. And I think I could just buy it, turn it around quickly. That's what today's all about.
The Mercedes SL sports car has been around since the 1950s, but it's the fourth generation model launched in 1989 that's on Paul's radar. With powerful engines, a luxurious interior, and a host of cutting-edge gadgets, the SL was an expensive car to buy new. But these days, they're the price of a second-hand hatchback, and Paul reckons now is the time to buy. Carl's asking just $6,000 for this 1989 SL, but it's a complex car, so there's lots for Paul to check.
Well, that sounds very happy. Let's now press a load of buttons and see what works.
The first thing you do when you check an old SL is make sure every switch correlates to a function and that function works, because if it doesn't, I guarantee it'll be expensive to fix.
So that's a good sign. So the roll bar works, the roof works, so the hydraulic pump's obviously all right.
If all of that works, it's a big sigh of relief because I can just take away loads of work out of the to-do list, and so far this car is good.
SLs came with a hardtop for use in the winter, and although Carl has one, it's seen better days.
Oh, a little bit of trim to do, isn't there? It's just gone a bit there, and we might need a headliner. Need to re-stick that all back together. The little bits of trim all need to go back in. There's a bit of bubbling in the corner where they always used to go. None of this puts me off, but all of this makes me want to buy it cheaper. There's much to love, mate. I have to say, there's an awful lot to love. The engine, the gearbox, the suspension, all perfect.
Good.
But a little bit to do is, you know, I would love to pay five, if that's possible.
I bet you would. No, five wouldn't do.
I just need to have that bit of wiggle room that should I get back and the worst should happen, and just got a bit of love left in it.
So, yeah, that's why it's six.
Well, you'd like six. I would love to get five. So shall we say five and a half, meet in the middle? Can I be out your hair? You'll never see me again.
Yeah. Cheers.
That's
a good deal, yeah.
Well, come and write me up then. Come on, let's have a brew and we'll do some paperwork.
Back at the workshop, it's time for Paul to fess up.
Hello, mate.
Hey. Oh,
there's no need for that.
Shut them bad boys out.
Put my sunglasses back on. That's a bit of glare. I'm actually quite glad you've got a bit of a sunny look today.
Why?
Because I've been out and I may have bought something.
You haven't bought a car on your own, have you?
I have. Wait there.
Oh, R129.
It's cool, isn't it?
That is good. Did somebody take you out shopping?
I did this all by myself.
No.
I did. Really nice, very early one. I think the best colour combination and the two-tone, which I think is the coolest as well.
Oh, yeah. Very underrated.
I think so. And very, very cheap at the moment. I paid $5,500 for that.
Get out of town. Has it been to the moon?
No. And it really drives rather well.
When he told me he'd bought a V8, I thought, oh, no, it's some American disaster of a car, because he loves all that stuff. So I was very pleasantly surprised. Design-wise, the car does have that typical Mercedes elegance, but they're a bit brutish as well. And they do build a cracking V8, and that's the combination you've got there. An incredibly usable car that will literally last forever. I mean, I'm tempted, to be honest, chuck a bucket of water over it, whack a grand on it, and put it back up.
There you go. Now we're talking. This was the whole point of this flip, basically. It was a cheap and easy car. So the roof needs a really good clean, probably a bit of re-dyeing, actually.
You can just polish money into that, to be honest.
You can. It's a nice car, solid but tatty, and it's all there.
All in all, boy's done good there. He has done well. He's bought a really good car. The hood and the interior just need a really good clean, couple of small repairs. Chuck a bucket of water over it, polish it to death, get it out the door.
Drew's decided to take the car to a company he knows in Shropshire for a thorough freshen up. But after a few miles on the road, it's clear the Merc's interior needs more than a spit and polish.
So, this is my first drive of the Mercedes. Outwardly, Paul's done well. Inwardly, putrid. It's absolutely disgusting. I don't really want to touch it. Everything is just filthy. It's like they've had a pup dog living in it. It's horrid.
Fortunately, Drew's on his way to meet Nigel Woodward, whose team at Classic Motor Cars tackles everything from minor detailing to nut and bolt restoration.
So we've been in existence for 26 years. So our chairman had a collection of cars that he needed to look after. So he sort of started the business off as a bit of a hobby business just to look after those cars. Everybody here is passionate about cars. We live and breathe it, absolutely.
Hello.
Drew.
How are you doing?
Welcome to Classic Motor Cars.
Nice to meet you.
Nice
what
to meet
a
you.
Place.
Thank you. Thank
oh,
you.
My word. Sure. Look at this.
Nigel's team are known for their work on classic Jaguars and are currently working on a very special car.
The last ever SS100 ever built for sale. So,
no.
There you are. It might be your lucky day.
I ain't that lucky. First impressions of classic motor cars, well, what can I say? I've seen some amazing garages and workshops in my time. The standard of the cars is world class. Now I'm going to have to show you our rather shabby Mercedes. It's just a little unloved.
It certainly hasn't seen the valet bay for a while, has it?
No.
I think a really good deep clean and really, really bring it back to life.
So I have no qualms at all about bringing our lowly little Mercedes in here, because they will work on your Morris Oxford or they will work on your lightweight E-Type here or anything in between.
Dan Brown is one of the firm's detailers and has turned cleaning cars into an art form.
On a scale of 1 to 10 of cars you've done, how bad is this one?
About 56.
That bad?
It's not nice, is it?
No, it's horrible.
Dan's first job is to give the interior an initial clean, and that's not pretty.
Oh, my God. Is that dirt?
Dead skin.
It stinks. The floor's sticky, the steering wheel's sticky, everything's just covered in this sort of black goo.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God, this is disgusting. Dan, poor guy, he's got to get through all that, but I know we're going to end up with a beautiful interior. This car, we're basically polishing money back into it. You love that. I mean, this is brilliant, just watching you do this. You're loving it, aren't you?
Yeah, so yeah, really enjoy
genuinely
it.
Genuinely good at this stuff.
Detailing to this standard will cost around £1,300, and for Drew, it's worth every penny.
Oh, look at that. There you go. That's night and day.
Paul wanted to keep costs to a minimum on this car, and there's still the tatty hardtop to deal with.
The headline has come adrift from the foam and it's hanging down, but one of the issues with it is it's shrunk, so you're always going to come up short is the problem, so we'll make a new liner for it.
Restoring the hardtop will add another £500.
So this car was meant to be, you know, throw a bucket of water over it, give it a service, get it out the door. It's too good for that, to be honest. Paul's bought a really good car to begin with. I'll leave it with you. Thank you very much.
Not at all. Thank you.
We're going to get back a pristine 500SL, which is going to sell easy. No problem at all. So I'm just off down to the unit to see Paul. Had the Mercedes back. It looks amazing, apparently. I can't wait to see what they've done. But I do also have to get past Paul a rather large bill. Hello, mate.
Hello, mate.
What do you think?
I love it.
You happy with it?
I like the result.
Good,
I'm not massively impressed with the bill, but they have done a very good job.
You know about the bill.
I have seen the bill. A little bit on the pricey side from the detailing, but I like what he's done. The bodywork is pretty much perfect now. Luckily, I bought the car so right in the first instance, we're all right with this one. Lovely interior now as well.
That smells beautiful, look.
And look at that headlining.
Oh, it smells like expensive shoes.
I wouldn't know.
The headlining is brilliant. It's actually, I think it's probably better than Mercedes did. And that's saying something. The standard of the work we've had done is extremely high for a cheap car. And it shows.
This car's been very helpful at the moment. And you survive on these. As a business, you survive on these quick flips. You just light the lights and pay the wages.
It looks great. What can you get for it?
Well, the car's 5.5. With everything you see, detailing, £2,000 to £7,500, but I do think that is shade under £10,000, that car. It's a V8 Roadster with over 300 horsepower for under £10,000. Now, find me any other car with a big V8 stuck up the front, all that power, that build quality, the integrity, the badge, everything else, it's going to be more.